Okay, student, today we start the second half, partial distribution. And immediately in the first lecture, today and next lecture, we will study the most powerful tool to solve three different partial equations that we learned in the second half. So I really ask for your absolute concentration. But anyway, first, so introduction student. What the partial distribution is, in fact, this still differential equation, but with function of several variables. So let's see that equation. For example, here you say derivative respect t and respect s. So you have function of two variables, student. And when you have function of several variables, when you take derivative, you must yield partial derivative. So the official name, this is partial differential equation that we call shortly PDE. Distinguished. First half, we learn ODE. This is ordinary function of one variable. And now second half, we learn PDE. This is partial function of several variables. In our second half, we will study three kinds of PDE. First, this is heat. Second, this is weight. And last, Laplace PDE. And I think, student, you can take a look. Do you see some similarity between heat and weight? Yes, you see both are U and T, and you have the derivative. Understand? But do you see also the difference between heat and weight? Heat, you have the derivative of T first order, derivative of U respect S second order. But for weight equation, both derivative respect T and S are second order. And the last thing, for the Laplace equation, you don't have T, you have only S and Y. So student, sometimes when you have equation with T, when you have equation with T, sometimes we call this a dynamic. But if equation has no T, sometimes we call static. Okay, so dynamic student, this is equation with time. But Laplace, this is no time. And the last notion, student. Here, for heat equation, you have first order derivative respect T, second order respect S. So what is the order of this PDE? We will call the highest order of partial derivative. Understand? Respect whatever variable, this is the order of PDE. So here for three equations that we will study that semester, you see you have different derivatives. But the highest order as on y second. So all three are second order DDA. Okay, but besides, this is the first order respective. Why this is the second order respective? And that last you have noted. And now the last important notation, student. Because you have function of several variables, here two variables, so the domain of that function is some domain in plane S and T. And if you have such domain, you will have boundary of domain. And if on boundary, the value of the function you must find is given, we will call that boundary condition Dirichlet condition. Understand? And generally, student, immediately you will see the use of the next statement. For general PDA, if you have equation inside and boundary condition like Dirichlet condition on boundary, so there is always and only one solution. That means, remember shortly, equation together with boundary condition will provide only one solution. Understand? So now, okay, this is on notion. Now we go directly straightforward to the bond today. But I must say the simulation technique for the heat equation is long. So let's train with the first order PDA. Now we ask you to solve that PDA equation. Partial derivative respect S equal 4 times partial derivative respect Y. Okay, now for this simple equation, student, I think you can immediately see the difficulty, the main difficulty of PDA. What the main difficulty is here, student? When you have differential equation, that means you have derivative. Which operation you must do to cancel derivative? Surely integral. But now, left hand side, you have derivative respect S. Right hand side, you have derivative respect Y. Can you take integral one time for both hand side, but respect different variable? No way. Do you agree with me? You can multiply ds to both hand side that integral, but in this case the right hand side is okay under the difficult integral. How you can take integral when inside you have derivative respect y and ds together? So now student, this is the main difficulty, but very very amazing the separation technique student allows us to escape integral. What you do now, the main thing, we will look for solution in this form, student. Let's find USY equal SS multiplying YY. What's the bond is here? So you student still function of two variable. Understand? But
two variables, they are separated. So you can see it looks like oil and water. You mix in one solution, but this not like salt in water. Oil on way above, water below, understand? So you have separated liquid. Now similarly, we have function of two variables, but they are separable. What happened with them? Now let's take the derivative respect S. What happened when you take this derivative? Y like constant. So you focus to only S. Similarly, UY, this A, S like constant, so you print outside. Do you see? If you suggest separated form, you can take easy derivative. Now, your equation becomes US, this A, UY so student, that's very special form allows us to take easy derivative. Now next advantage student, if you have separable form for both hand side, you can print on S to one hand side, on Y to other hand side. So that means you will have S prime over S equal 4 times Y prime over Y. But now student, we have some strange phenomenon here. You see left hand side depends only on S. So if S change, left hand side change. Right hand side depends only on Y. But they are equal for on S Y. Do you understand? So it looks like I touch two brands. Understand? And now you are here, your brand in order room. Here you do anything, follow only your will. There, on order room, your brand does similarly on thing that you want. Can happen that your action and his action on Y the same. Do you understand? But now this happen. How? This can happen. The only thing that the left and the right are equal constant. Do you understand? So okay, return to your example. You are here. He is there. But you cannot do. You do anything, you do nothing. You just sit down, I ask you, don't move. And there, your friend does the same thing, just sit down. Understand? Only in this case, we can say that your action and his action are always the same. You're with me? So now, student, the very important point of separable technique, you bring S one hand side, Y other hand side, you see left, depend on S, right, depends on Y. So if they are equal, they must be the same constant.
Okay, we will not disable lambda constant. So now, student, what happened now? You will receive the first equation that one equal lambda. But when the left equal lambda student, do you still have PDE? Let's see equation S prime over S equal lambda. Do you still have PDE? Is there function of two variables? No. Now you have only function of one variable. That means now you return to the first half. You don't have any more PDE. You have only ODA. This is the bond there. We try to transform from PDE to ADE. And now you will see the solution of the first one is this is simulable. I will rewrite student S prime like DS over this small S. So you will have that one. Equal lambda, understand? And the second equation the same. Dy over y. Dy, this is lambda over 4. And now by usual technique, you bring ds to right hand side. You take integral. You have integral df over s equal integral lambda d small s. So you have logarithm s equal lambda s plus logarithm c1. So you have s. This is c1 exponential lambda s. Similarly, for the second equation. But now for y, and instead of lambda, you have lambda over 4, understand? So you will have answer. But student, we don't find the final goal. This not s and y, the final goal is the function u. So you this a s multiply y. And when we multiply c1 and c2, we get like new constant c. So you have this a c exponential lambda s plus lambda over 4y. So now you must find c and lambda, and attention, we have one condition that we did not use. So now that's a condition type. We get s equals 0. So u 0 y, this is c. But that condition I understand. And now How this can happen, I think, without any mathematics, direct or not directly, C must be I, and lambda over 4, this is 3. But still done.
I must say that this solution, I believe, will raise some good students here. Teacher, do you have such technique at your high school? Let's imagine that if high school teacher asks you to solve some equation, you start with one suggestion. Now, I will suggest S in some special form. Can teacher accept? Never. So this technique, you can say rightly, teacher, this technique allows us to find only one special solution. Understand? And our goal this is the set of all solutions, the general solution. We can lose some solution here. So this not our final solution, teacher. But let's see this condition still done. When, if you have such equation, so your domain still done, A, O, S, Y. And now you have condition when S equals 0, S equals 0 is that 1. So you see that line boundary. Understand? If you solve the equation on right half and together with boundary condition, what we already mentioned in last five student, equation inside boundary condition together. So how many solutions you have? Only one. Did you find such solution? We found it. So student, the statement that we mentioned last time, generally the BDA has only one solution. So now by whatever technique, if you find one solution, this is the solution you must find. Do you understand? So now student, we get that severable suggestion very, very relaxed form. Understand? And we never scare that we lose some solution else. So here, that one, equation plus BC, that means boundary condition. So you have only one. Oh, this is the problem when I try together with microphone student. And that is that one. So if you understand student, now I leave you for some practice. Let's solve that one.
Tôi cũng không thể nào quấy rầy các em với cái bài thơ nổi tiếng đó. Xin mời.
Ok, let's solve that solution problem. Okay, I invite you out to outside. If you don't want to move, I move myself. And within this free time, if some of you feel that you can solve, you can go to the bar, try that solution, and earn some activity club. Now I check for attendance. Ngọc Bảo, Nguyễn Dũng, Em Sàng, Đình Duy, Hoàng Duy, Thanh Hải, Tiến Hải, Thanh Hiệp, Trung Hiếu, Chí Học, Ngọc Hân, Tuấn Hùng, Mạnh Huy, Đức Huy, Quang Huy, Gia Huy, Nguyên Khang, Kim Khánh, Ngọc Khánh, Áp Sàng, Tấn Khải, Đăng Khoa, Minh Khoa, Kim Ký, Hoàng Long, Duy Long, Minh Luân, Trọng Nam, Áp Sàn, Trung Nguyên, Hoài Nhân, Gia Phúc, Áp Sàn, Minh Quân, Minh Quang, Lý Thành, Em Sàng, Ngọc Thiện, Công Thức, Minh Tiến, Hữu Trường, Hoàng Tuấn, Đăng Tùng, Quang Tùng, Phú Minh, Minh Vũ, Quốc Điền, ít cũng là em biết Hữu Trường. Ok. Thank you.
Okay, what's the final solution? Okay. So it looks like, or let's read the final form. U equal is multiply y power 3. Okay, so now okay, now let's solve very fast, student. If some of you have difficulty, let's follow my discussion one more time. Take derivative and substitute. Green on term with S. So you have first equation. So now you can print on term here. That integral. Similarly. You will have y, this a, so you this a c, you use the condition, you will have c multiply okay, I think you understand the simulation technique. Now, we move student to the important the simulation technique now for the heat, the real PDA. Any question? You can suggest, don't worry. Okay, so if you still have questions, you can ask me later. So now student, because it requires a long process, so now we continue with our prep only when we obtain the final solution, understand? With that later prep. I want to be sure that the recording file is not interrupted. That's all. So now, student. Say only one thing forward. The discussion is long, but later, you need only two times for all students. You remember the general form of solution. For good students, you remember only the main idea. And after that, you can develop. So first discussion is still that we have the heat equation derivative respect T equal 4 times second derivative respect S on S from 0 to pi. And we have some conditions. First, let's discuss the picture why we have three conditions. Let's sketch the domain. So now you have equation for ST, so I will sketch student. This is the plane. And the first condition, S equals 0, so you have that one. The next condition, S equals pi. S equals pi, this still vertical line. And finally, the last condition, T equals 0, so you have that side. So we say, in fact, L domain S from 0 to pi, T greater than 0, this is one rectangle, but infinitive rectangle, understand? And this rectangle has how many sides for boundary student? Three sides. So that's why you have three conditions here. You can say that on a boundary conditions, but in fact, student, we distinguish. You see, when S, when T equals 0, that one. When T equals 0, physically, we usually call that kind of condition S. What happens when you have some problem with time and you have condition when time equals 0, student? We call this a initial condition. So that condition till 0, student, we call initial condition, I say. And to all the condition when S equals 0, when S equals pi, this loop real boundary, understand? So this one, we call boundary. That means student. In fact, all condition here are boundary, but we classify one like initial, T equals 0, others like boundary. And now, how we solve that problem, we will use student three steps. First step, student, we try to transform PDA into ODA. Understand? Next, we solve ODA and we will touch the general form. A condition. And finally, we find all missing constant there. So that means the initial condition will say the last one. So now, step one. Here, student. One more time, we use the separation technique. ST equal SSTT. So when you substitute derivative respect T, you have T prime multiply S equal 4 times second derivative respect S. So this is S2 prime multiply T. Understand? And now, one more time, we print S one hand side T for order. So you have S to bring S over S equal T prime T for T.
and one more time left depends on S, right depends on T. So it must be lambda equal constant. Understand? But we don't stop here, still done. We will see what the boundary condition for U now becomes for S. Let's see, student, you have U 0t under that assumption. This will be S0 multiply tt equal 0. And what happens when the product equals 0, student? At least one term must be 0. So now, the first case, if S0 like number different from 0, so you will have tt must be 0 for all t. And if t equals 0, how about function u? U equals 0. Understand? And that solution, student, we call trivial solution. And here, temporarily, we don't consider trivial solution. That means we try to look for solution non-trivial. We will understand perfectly at the end why at that step we don't study, we don't touch trivial condition, zero solution in our consideration. Understand? So here, that one. Trivial so temporarily we exclude from our study trivial solution. So student, the second case S0 equals 0. Understand? So that one we touch. Similarly, the condition U by T and one more time we look for only non-trivial. So what conclusion you get here? When S by multiply TT equals 0, still done. S by still 0. Understand, we don't spend attention to the case S by different from 0. So finally, student, for S, you will have problem S to prime minus lambda S equals 0. And S0 equals S by equals 0. For T, you will have T prime T minus for lambda T. This is 0. So this is 2 ODA. Understand? So the first step finished. Here, one explanation, student. Some of you can ask me, teacher, why you touch number 4 for T? Why you don't touch number 4 for the hand side with S? The problem is, student, now you have two different problems for S and for T. Which one will you start? You can see T, this is first order easier, but S we have more condition. So we will start from S. So that's why we want the equation with S, S symbol, simplest as possible. Do you understand? So all the factors I will bring for T. I will fit it with T later. But now we start with S, so we want our evolution. Understand?
and seamless.
Okay, so the first step finished. Now we attack straight forward to the second step. And I to rewrite the equation that we have already here. So now, student, what you can tell me for this equation? S to prime minus lambda Fs equals 0.
If you still have derivative, my advice, let us for the sample number lambda equal 3. If I ask you S to prime minus lambda S minus 3s equals 0, what you must do? Let that lambda like any number, understand? For this symbol, lambda equal 3. So you will find out OC equation. You recognize this equation, this is just the second order ODE homogeneous. And you must write the auxiliary. So now, absolutely similar, please, student, we will consider that one like
that equation is homogeneous. So you touch that one. Understand?
And what is your k now? K squared equal lambda. K equal plus minus square root lambda. Are you sure? Okay, depend on lambda. If lambda negative, we must involve number I. If lambda positive, so here student like 9 class, you have 3 cases. Lambda greater than 0, lambda equal 0, lambda smaller than 0. And we will show you only one from 2 first cases. I chose same layer to show why we never take 2 first case in consideration. So student here,
that means you have 3 cases. And when lambda greater than 0, you will have exponential solution. Understand? Lambda equals 0. Now the this guy we will write longer. You have k1 equal k2 equal 0. So your solution is S equal Riley C1 multiply exponential 0s. That means C1 multiply 1. Plus C2 S exponential 0s. And condition S0, you substitute S0, so you have this is C1. Understand? And at that time, if you use S by the next condition, C1 equals 0 already. So one more time, you have C0 equals 0. But when C1 and C2 equals 0, that means when C1 and C2 equals 0, S equals 0. And when S equals 0, so you have
U equals zero, and this is our trivial solution. So we don't take this to study. Similarly, student, we can show if you have exponential or polynomial solution, the boundary condition S0 equals S pi equals 0 always leads you to zero solution. Do you understand? So, three cases we never study, we accept student, you can say same layer, teacher, or to first kind, the boundary condition and the non-trivial assumption student leads us to zero solution. Understand? Okay. Now, we focus to the last case. When lambda negative, I suggest lambda equal minus mu square. Okay, we take mu positive. Understand? So, your equation k square equal lambda will be minus mu square. Or I involve number I. So this is mu square, I square. So you have k this is plus minus mu I. Do you understand? So alpha equal zero, beta equal mu. So your solution S will be C1 cos mu s plus C2 sin mu s. Now, let's take the condition S0. If you substitute S equals 0 there, so what you have? S equals 0. Sin 0. This is 0. And cos 0. This is 1. So C1, this is 0, student. So now your solution reduced to only C. Understand? You continue with S by. So S by student, in this case, we will see 2 sin mu by. One more time, the product is 0. So what can happen? What happened if C2 is 0? Okay, trivial. So your dream come true. So teacher, you, this you, who said that now we don't study true solution. And I show that you just said two first cases on why trivial. Now the last case, we have C1, this is 0, and we have C2, this is 0, one more time, trivial. So we have no study now. We can leave. Sorry for you. The second term, C, we buy, destroys your dream. Okay, if this one equals 0, one more time, this is trivial. So we cannot touch, understand? We must touch the cây sin mu pi this is zero student. And what happened if sin this is zero? Okay, like high school, ninth class. Do you remember sin s equals zero, s equals
zero?
Okay, right. Very right. You just said your idol star. What's his name? Please, next week, remember me, his name, and his star. 2 weeks later, remember me one more time. Sin S equals 0, so S equals K by. K, this is integer number. Not only zero as you dream, as you are obsessed. The number zero will follow you. So student, okay, I don't use number K there. K, this is already the symbol that we use operation. We will write mi by equal M by, where M this is integer number. Understand? So mi equal M, but we not mi positive here. So now student, finally, instead of M, I will touch mi, this is N, where N, natural number. And so student, finally, you will have lambda, this is minus mi square, that means minus N square. Your solution, now not only one, but intuitive. This is sin NS, sin mu S here, understand? Why we don't not see the constant? You will see it later. And now student, that one finish for S. But now, don't stop here, because you must have the T. How about T student? You have equation T prime over 4T equal lambda. So you have equation T prime like dt by dt minus 4 lambda T. That means plus 4 n square T equal 0. Understand? And this is separable. Easy ODA, tắt đi T by left hand side. Bring T there, student. So you will have minus 4 N T dt, tắt integral. And what you have for T student? Logarit T, this is minus 4 n square t plus logarit d. Understand? So now you have solution tn. This is d exponential 4 n square t. And finally, of second step, student. Student, you have solution for S, sin. You have solution for T, exponential. And your yield, this is SS TT, understand? So you have the kind of exponential minus 4 N square sin NS N greater or equal 1. And finally, what you must do now? Teacher, you have not only one solution, but infinite solution. What you do? Remember, student, like homogeneous equation. When you have Y1, Y2 in solution, so your final solution is C1Y1 plus C2Y2. Here, if you bring U to left hand side, right hand side still zero, your equation is linear and homogeneous, so you yield the same root. If you have some solution, like basic solution, your final solution will be the sum of basic solution. But the problem now, you have the sum of not only one term, but infinite term. And the sum of infinite term, we call, what is the name of the sum of infinite term? We already studied last semester, FA4 building, I remember. Morning, you have several variables. Bachelor,
And afternoon, you have calculus to the sum of every term. I remember some students try to go to the bar, so I'm sorry, like you. But now, you don't remember. So I think that last semester, you did me. Okay, now that's time to retreat you. I will give you the score that you worked last semester. When I say that semester, you don't remember. No. 10, okay. And mostly. So now, what is the name of the sum of every term?
Student. All the class, I am not sure because I saw student, I think they didn't study with me, but you studied with me last semester.
The
sum when n from 1 to infinity. Oh, one secret. Oh, yes, you mean that? Okay. Good news. So, Mr. Võ Hoàng Duy, what we must do now, very easy. My daughter now is still abroad. She will return later. So, I want to keep Mr. Võ Hoàng Duy near me. So, I can talk to him. So, okay. I think you can consider your presentation every ED class next semester and next year. I must be sure that you are there. I give you chance. Don't fulfill your dream.
Firstly, stay in there forever.
So now, return student, what is the name, English name, of the sum series?
Very easy. So now, student, don't surprise that. We saw.
I must say why I highlight that point. A lot of students, they cannot remember formula. And first question from them for me, teacher, why in ODE we have such solution? But when you remember the sum of infinite series, now you can understand your final answer here, student. This A. U is the sum n from 1 to 50 multiplied constant that we know pn exponential minus 4n squared t sin ns. Do you understand? It's very long, but it's reasonable. Okay, now I rewrite one more time. Student, we have okay, the bond A here, student, I like to recall you that, for example, if you take equation, easy, y square, y2 prime minus y equals 0, how to solve it? You take k square minus 1, and you have how many k? Understand? In fact, excuse me, k is equal 1 and k is equal minus 1. And now, from k, in fact, you can show that y1 is exponential s, y2 is exponential minus s, and solution of that one. But this is only particular.
But very, very specific that we call basic solution. And now from basic solution, how you can find the general solution? Y this A, C1, Y1 plus C2, Y2. Let's see what happens with that equation if I bring that term to right-hand side. Left-hand side. Do you see some similarity between this ODE and that PDE? First, Y like variable. So you have left-hand side on with Y, right, this is zero. We call homogeneous. Here, U this is variable. So left, this is U. On term with U, right, this is zero. Next, for ODE, you find two basic solutions. So your solution general, this is the sum. Here, you have how many basic solutions? On exponential multiplication, arrive with n greater or equal 1. Do you understand? So, your solution, your general rule will be the same. Multiply constant, that's the sum. And the sum, this is not the sum of two terms or 10 terms, but infinite terms. So you have 7. But I must assure you, don't worry, series is just informed because now for some easy next step student, you will can solve the series side very fast. So now, do we treat on condition already? Did we use on condition? No, this still initial. So if you touch t equal zero student, so first, exponential of 0, this is 1. You will have bn sin ns, this is the function u, equal that 1, 3 sin s minus 5 sin 4s. So now let's see the last identity. You must see that the left hand side is the sum of sin, but the right hand side is the sum of sin 2. So like the last step for first order BDA, you can apply any condition you want just to be sure that the left and the side, the right are the same. So how we do that? Sin s here, this is n equal 1. So you get B1, this is 3. Do you say sin ns comes with Bn? Ns sin 4s, that means n equal 4. So you have B4, this is minus 5. And how about order Bn? Okay, cancel. For on n different 1, 4. Understand? And now you can write the final solution. You this a first b1, so you have 3 n equal 1, so minus 40 sin s. Understand? Next n equal 4, b4 this is minus 5, so minus 5 exponential. N equal 4, so 16 multiply 4, so minus 64 t sin 4n, and this is the final solution. Okay, I think you really worry if the solution is too long like that. So how we can solve one problem?
I like
to take one book, the extra book, but I don't see here, don't worry, I will write immediately one exercise I remember similar in the extra book. And now you will see we find solution for 1 minute. Okay, what I suggest you now, student, lesson. In this part, identify S from 0 to pi, understand? And we have the same boundary condition. And we have that one. So now how we solve? In fact, student, the problem seems very long, but when you repeat your study, do you have to do new thing? You suggest the same simulation form, you substitute, you bring the term to F, right? So you must see that your solution for C, because you bring the number 4, last time number 4 here, student, 2T. So the form for sin must be the same, sin and s. And the number 4 you used last time appears in the final form only for exponential. So that means now you can write directly UST, what your UST is. Read loudly together with me the series symbol n from 1 to bt of how much student? Bn. Later you will see you will have cos answer. So we use a for cos, b for sin. And next, exponential minus 5 n squared t, understand? Sin and s. And now you treat the intuition, you substitute, you get the sum Bn sin nf, this a for sin 3f. So you have only one b different from 0, this a b 3 equal 4. And your final answer, student, B3, that means we take n equal 3, n equal 3, so this is 9 multiply 5, exponential minus 45t, sin 3s, that's all. That's why, student, we spend a lot of attention to the separation discussion. But when you understand, you need not repeat on the step, on the previous steps. Okay? And here, to student, to last attention. Suppose you can worry that you misunderstand or you remember formula with mistake. Anyway, I think you can check. Student, what happened with that formula? If you substitute s equal 0 and s equal pi inside your formula, s equal 0 here, you have sin 0, and sin 0 is on y 0. So the sum of 0 is 0. You dare not say 0. So now you cannot escape your real 0. Last time you say 0, but it's not 0. But now you don't say 0, but it cannot save your life. Your life still 0. And next, if you substitute s equal pi, you have here sin. No, no. For the 0 formula, if you substitute pi here, you have sin n pi with n natural number,
like sin 5, sin 2 by, sin 3 by, sin 4 by, understand? And all sin there are 0 to lighter. You miss already your chance. So one more time, you have U equals 0. Do you understand? So now you cannot, student, if you check, you cannot write formula with this stuff. Don't forget the sign minus here, because later we will say the sign minus means physically something. Okay, so now this is on for the very important session. Now let us rest 10 minutes.